Thank you. Young Narendranath's initial belief was shaped and influenced by Brahmo Samaj's concepts and doctrines, that is, worshipping one God, discarding idol worship. There, he was realizing their religious lectures by seeing God. He asked many scholars the same question, that is, have you seen God? But he never got an answer to his question. Finally, he went to meet Ramakrishna at Dakshineshwar in 1882. There too, without much ado, he directly asked Ramakrishna, "Sir, have you seen God?" Ramakrishna smiled calmly and then answered his question, "Yes, I have seen God, just as I see you here, only in a more clear sense." Narendra was astounded and puzzled. He could feel the man's words were honest and uttered from the depths of experience. After that, he started visiting Ramakrishna frequently.
Here I would like to share a background of the different nature of Swami Vivekananda. It was Narendra's nature to test something truly before he could accept it. Narendra did not accept Ramakrishna as his guru without a test. Ramakrishna used to say that in order to realize God, one should give up the desire for money and women. One day, Narendra hid a big coin under his pillow. Sri Ramakrishna, who had gone out, and came into his room and stretched himself on the cot. He jumped as if he was bitten by a scorpion, and he shook his mattress. A rupee coin fell down. Later he came to know that it was the doing of Narendra. Narendra accepted Ramakrishna as his guru and took training under for 5 years in the Advaita Vedanta, the philosophy of non-dualism. Ramakrishna passed away in 1886 and nominated Narendra as his successor. After his death, Narendra and a core group of Ramakrishna's disciples took course to become monks and renounced everything and started living in Paranagur.
Swamiji mesmerized everyone in America with his masterful oratory. Wherever he went, he dwelt at a length on the greatness of Indian culture. He spoke with a spontaneous ease on every topic, be it a history, sociology, philosophy, or literature. He deplored the malicious propaganda that had been unleashed by the Christian missionaries in India. Swami Vivekananda also went to England. Many people became his disciples. The most famous among them was Margaret Nivedita. She came to India and settled here. In 1893, Swami Vivekananda went to America to attend the Conference of the World Religions in Chicago. He earned a wide applause for beginning his address with the famous words, "Sisters and Brothers of America." Swamiji mesmerized everyone in America with his masterful oratory. Wherever he went, he dwelt at a length on the greatness of Indian culture. He spoke with a spontaneous ease on every topic, be it a history, sociology, philosophy, or literature. he deplored the malicious propaganda that had been unleashed by the Christian missionaries in India. Swami Vivekananda also went to England. Many people became his disciple. The most famous among them was Margaret Nivedita. She came to India and settled here. Swami Vivekananda returned back to India in 1897 after 4 years of touring in the West. He started disseminating the message of spiritual development among Indians. During the next 2 years, Swami Vivekananda bought a site at Bendoru on the river bank of Ganga. He constructed buildings and established Sri Ramakrishna Mutt. He once again toured the West from January 1899 to December 1900.
One of India's most important resources is the youth. Swami Vivekananda's birthday is celebrated as a National Youth Day. The government of India has quoted that the philosophy of Swamiji and ideals for which he lived and worked were a great source of inspiration for Indian Youth Day. All the powers within you and you can do something and everything. This mantra of Vivekananda is as effective, relevant and inspiring today as it was in the days of colonization. Now, India is ready to be a global leader. With the power of yoga and the energy that comes from spirituality, the youth of India are ready to give directions to the world. Swami Vivekananda's lessons still inspire the youth. Make a life's aim and incorporate that idea in your life. Think about it over and over again. Dream it, live it. This is the secret of being successful. His mantra for the youth is evergreen. Until you can trust yourself, you cannot trust Allah or God. Swami Vivekananda has taught the world that it is our duty to encourage all those doing good so that they can make their dreams come true. He has motivated the youth, and if they follow his instructions and ideas, then India has a better future. So, as a youth today, follow and be inspired by Vivekananda's principle.
Let's build a new